six-figure watches, million-dollar sports cars, an entire mansion collection. These are eight things LeBron James owns that cost more than your life. And we always see NBA players dress up for interviews, but no one does it like LeBron. You see this fit? Just the suit cost LeBron $4,900. But he's not gonna stop there. I mean, we're talking about the GOAT. So, this man slapped an Audemars Piguet on his wrist too, worth over $31,000. And that goofy looking purse turned out to be an exclusive, custom-made Thom Browne alligator skin bag, worth over $41,000. Sheesh. And you throw in the little accessories like socks, headphones, sunglasses, this entire fit costs $78,000. Ridiculous. Landing this outfit and number 8 on our list. But let's be honest, all right? That's just play money for LeBron. The man has spent more on a single pair of shoes. Yeah, you heard me right. One pair of shoes costs more than that entire fit. Back in 2018, LeBron scored his 30,000th career point and made NBA history. So, Nike wanted to congratulate him with these one-of-a-kind diamond and gold LeBron 15s, made of genuine crocodile skin, finished in 24 karat gold. And the detail in these shoes are on another level. Riri zippers, custom zipper pulls, heel clips, lace loops, all made of solid gold, and diamond shoelace tips. What? Imagine LeBron, game 7 of the finals, pulling up for a game-winning 3 in his diamond and gold sneakers. That's legendary. But I don't think he's trying to ruin these shoes, cause they cost over $100,000 to make, which takes the number 7 spot on our list. But you know, like I said, we're talking about the GOAT here. $100,000 is like Bronny's allowance. So let's talk about the millions that LeBron spent on designer watches. Yeah, across his 3 Rolexes, 3 Audemars Piguets, 2 Patek Philippes, and a Richard Mille, LeBron's watch collection totals to $894,000. Jesus! Wait, hold on. I forgot to include his second Richard Mille. The Richard Mille Signature 1103 Automatic Flyback Chronograph. This watch is crazy, cause it doesn't even need batteries. It's charged by aggressive physical activity. So anytime LeBron's playing basketball, he's charging up this watch. So when you add on this $377,000 Richard Mille, his entire collection is worth over $1.2 million, making these watches number 6 on our list. But if this man is dropping that much on his wrist, can you even imagine how much LeBron spends on his cars? See, LeBron's been building a multi-million dollar car collection since 2002, before he even got an NBA check. Yeah, at just 18 years old, this man went out and bought himself a brand new Hummer. And that was only the beginning, because when LeBron was drafted in 2003, and he finally did start making that NBA money, he bought a Jeep Wrangler, a Chevy Camaro, a Dodge Challenger. Hell, LeBron even copped a classic 1975 Chevrolet Impala. Now, you know, those cars are cool and all, but LeBron's a guy making millions a year. Like, where's the Lambos and the Ferraris? Well, up to this point, LeBron had no reason to cop some exotic cars. He was just trying to stay humble. Until one fateful day in 2009. See, back then, LeBron was teammates with the legendary Shaquille O'Neal, and the two became pretty good friends. So, for LeBron's 25th birthday, Shaq gave him a brand new $450,000 Rolls-Royce Phantom. And after LeBron started driving this thing around, he realized he could never go back to a normal car. So from this point on, it's exotics only. I'm talking a custom wrapped Lamborghini Aventador, a Bentley Continental GT, a Porsche 911 Turbo, a Porsche 918 Spider. He even copped 3 different Ferraris, one of them with Subscribe to Rebound painted on the side. Yeah, that's right. Even the kings out here subscribe to the channel. So if you're not, then what the hell are you doing? And to top everything off, when LeBron won the NBA Finals in 2020, he decided to treat himself with his most expensive car yet, a Mercedes-Maybach G650 Landaulet, one of the rarest cars in the world, with only 99 in existence. And this thing cost LeBron $1.8 million. And when you add up all of LeBron's cars, his collection is worth over $6.4 million, landing his garage at number 5 on our list. Now, clearly, LeBron spends a lot on himself, but what does he do for charity? Well, being a kid from Akron, Ohio, LeBron had it rough growing up. His dad was in prison, his mom couldn't hold down a job, and he bounced around the most dangerous neighborhoods in the city. Obviously, the violence was traumatic for a young LeBron. Being so young and feeling so powerless, LeBron knew something needed to change. So he swore that one day he'd come back to Akron and stop the violence for good. And in 2018, LeBron finally got his chance. In collaboration with the Akron Public School Department, LeBron opened up his very own I Promise School, where students can get the help that LeBron and his friends never had. Free transportation, food, and college tuition. All for the sake of keeping kids off of the street. And this was all that LeBron ever wanted.
When you see this, what do you think?
It's still so surreal. I don't know. I mean, it's hard, Don, to even be like, this is my school. It's like, I never envisioned having a school. I envisioned, you know, being in the community, giving back to my community in some way. But I never thought that it would turn into a school. But this is above and beyond.
Now, this kind of community service isn't cheap, because this school is costing LeBron $2 million per year. So up to this point, LeBron has spent over $8 million on this school, which takes the number 4 spot on our list. But LeBron's no fool, all right? $2 million a year is a lot of money to spend. And he knows that one day his NBA checks are gonna stop coming in. So back in 2012, LeBron found a new way to make tens of millions of dollars. Investing. See, after stepping into Blaze Pizza, a restaurant that no one had ever heard of, LeBron had the best slice of pizza he's ever tasted. So he knew exactly where to put his money. And with that, LeBron invested $1 million into Blaze Pizza. And this turned out to be a great move, because just 3 years later, Blaze Pizza became the fastest growing restaurant chain in the world. And LeBron's investment ended up being worth $35 million, grabbing the number 3 spot on our list. Damn, this man really turned a million into 35. That's some genius shit. But I'm not sure how much $35 million is really gonna help LeBron, because the man has a spending habit that's costing him hundreds of millions of dollars. Yeah, LeBron's got a reputation for buying mega mansions. And it all started in 2003, when LeBron was drafted by the Cavs. Not even a year into his rookie season, LeBron went out and copped his first mansion, a 30,000 square foot property in Bath Township, Ohio. And this house is insane. Not only does it have 6 bedrooms and 8 bathrooms, but it has a bowling alley, a personal movie theater, an aquarium, a recording studio. It even has a damn barber shop. This isn't even a house, this is a whole ass mall. And this mansion cost over $9 million. But LeBron's habit of buying houses was just getting started. Cause in 2010, when LeBron signed with the Heat, what was he supposed to do? Fly from Cleveland to Miami every night? Hell no. So he started house hunting again, until he found a $9 million mansion in Miami. This estate has a wine cellar, a rooftop deck, an infinity pool, an island bar, a concrete dock, and an entire guest house. But obviously, LeBron's not playing in Miami anymore. So, when he signed with the Lakers a few years ago, it was time to buy another mega mansion. And he landed on a $21 million estate in Brentwood. This place is so ridiculous, it literally has its own elevator. With the way that this dude is buying mansions, I wouldn't be surprised if LeBron bought another house in the same neighborhood at this point. Wait a second. He did do that. For some reason, he went out and bought another mansion in Brentwood. Except this time, he dropped $24 million on the place. And finally, he wrapped up his house buying addiction with his most expensive purchase yet. A 9,000 square foot mansion located right in the heart of Beverly Hills. And this beast of a house cost LeBron $37 million. This brings his grand total of money spent on mansions to $100 million, claiming the number two spot on our list. Most NBA players don't even make $100 million, and LeBron is out here dropping that much on five different mansions. This man has got to be out of his mind. Like, these have to be the most expensive things LeBron owns. Right? Well, actually, it turns out that LeBron does own something else that's worth even more than $100 million. See, back in 2011, when LeBron was in investor mode, he was looking for ways to really make his money multiply. And we're not talking about tens of millions of dollars. No, LeBron was looking to make hundreds of millions of dollars. And when he found out that the average soccer team was worth over $2 billion, he immediately wanted in. So he called up Fenway Sports Group, the owners of Liverpool Soccer Club, and ended up buying a 2% stake in the team for $6.5 million. And this was the single best financial decision of LeBron's entire life. Because by 2020, his 2% ownership became worth over $82 million.
Sheesh.
And LeBron was so happy with his investment that he actually went back to Fenway Sports Group looking for another deal. But this time, he had his eyes set on their baseball team, the Boston Red Sox. So in 2021, he bought a 1% stake in the team for $70 million. In total, this man literally owns $150 million worth of sports teams, securing the number one spot on our list. Unbelievable. But hey, at least LeBron can say that he owns some pretty cool stuff, because not every NBA player can say the same. Some NBA players buy weird things. Like, one player dropped $100,000 on an ugly ass chain of his own face. Another bought two bloodthirsty animals to keep his pets. Oh, you want to hear more about that? Then click on this video right here. These are the weirdest things NBA players actually buy. And trust me, man, you don't want to miss this one, all right? So what are you doing? This video's over. Click it.